The hardest type of building to convert into a house is without doubt a church. Just look at this place, it's huge, it's gloomy. No wonder there are so many derelict churches all over Britain that are just slowly disintegrating. To take on a church, you'd need to be passionate, committed, even fearless.
Dean Marks lives with his wife Hillary, a teaching assistant, his daughter Abby, and stepson Jonathan in a small rented house near Birmingham. They desperately need more space.
Jonathan's got Asperger's syndrome, which is a type of autism, and he can't walk very far. If things get any worse and he has to end up in a wheelchair or something, then our house isn't big enough at all. We need a bigger space to live.
They're hoping their saviour will be St Martin's Church. Dean has been desperate to buy it for years, so when it finally came on the market 4 years ago, he snapped it up.
It was like the grandeur as you walked round the side and saw the great big long windows, and then the same day I made an offer for the building. It is a dream. There is no way an average working class family could afford to buy that sort of space, no matter where it is.
Good Lord. It's huge.
It's larger than most people have.
How on earth are you going to convert this? What's it going to be?
It's going to be a five-bedroomed house with five bathrooms, formal dining room, kitchen, lounge, study, library. Where you stood now is you'll be in the middle of a swimming pool.
Of course you will.
Yes.
So you'll walk in the front door over there, yes, by the stained glass window, yep, and you'll look straight down along the swimming pool?
Yes.
How extraordinary. It's not a Baptist church, is it?
No, it's not.
This beautiful Georgian church was built in 1797. It's a Grade II listed building with 12 stained glass windows and a mahogany balcony that has to be preserved. Carving up these vast interior spaces to make a family home is a contentious and difficult thing to do.
So who are you working with if you had some help drawing up the plans?
No.
No professional help at all?
No.
Is that wise? I mean, I can't believe it is, because an architect is there to help guide you through all the niceties of looking after a building like this, you know, all these conservation issues, and to help you kind of refine the vision.
I have designed it. I've done the drawings. It's my baby, and I'm going to build it.
I am amazed that Dean is willing to take on such a massive project. Although he's a builder, he's never restored an old building before. Nevertheless, he's already come up with his own rather quirky layout. On the ground floor, the chancel of the church will make a grand hallway with a full-height stained glass window, which will lead to a living room the full width of the church. Dean and Hillary want their new home to reflect its history. Indeed, they have to keep a certain number of the building's features, like the stained glass windows and the ceramic floors. Along one side, there'll be a study and utility room, and on the other, a long dining room. At the far end of the building, there'll be a big open-plan kitchen that'll stretch the full width of the building. All the ground floor rooms will draw some light through the stained glass windows. But this leaves an odd space in the centre, which will have no windows and no natural light. So Dean's decided to put a swimming pool here, which Jonathan will use for physiotherapy. Upstairs, there are more challenges because Hillary and Dean have to keep the Grade II listed balcony. Seems a shame, but Dean's solution is to completely encase it to form a new first floor above. The space up here will comfortably accommodate four bedrooms all en suite, and a very generous master bedroom suite, all of which will be lit by the paler glass windows upstairs. And through this arrangement, a central corridor will run the length of the building, leading to a balcony that overlooks the double height space in the downstairs living area.
It does occur to me, though, standing here, that this building, despite the big windows, has no views. And all the light entering the building is going to be coloured by the stained glass, isn't it, more or less?
Yes.
How will you feel being stuck in this place? I mean, you're going to wake up in the morning, you're not exactly going to be bathed in white light, are you?
No, but it'll be nice sunlight, hopefully, coming through the nice stained glass windows.
And then we'll put lights on the outside, so when it's dark, the lights from the outside will flood in and give us different coloured lights through each room.
Dean and Hillary are also tackling the bell tower, rebuilt in the 1950s.
That goes right the way down.
Oh, wow. You could live in this really comfortably. You could convert just the tower.
The bell tower is one of the quirkier features of the church, and it'll provide Hillary and Dean with some more intimate private spaces. The ground floor will become a breakfast room, and above, there'll be a library with a spiral staircase leading up to a room at the top that'll be capped with a polycarbonate dome.
This is going to be the jewel in the crown.
A plastic dome?
Yes. The reason being, we would like to put an observatory so that you can stand up there and be able to turn 360 degrees and look at the views over the whole of the Black Country.
It'll be our space, I think. It'll be somewhere we can come up and sit and do what we want to do, and the kids are doing what they want to do. And I just want that to be
somewhere very private.
Very private, yeah.
Yeah.
I find Dean's plans worryingly unorthodox and unsympathetic to the building, but at least his heart is in the right place. Left empty for much longer, this church would be trashed or vandalised. Like many people, Dean has been seduced by the idea of rescuing an old building.
I'd always liked the idea to convert a church. They are built of such a soundness. It's got the making of a superb family home.
How do you feel, Hillary? I mean, do you feel equally passionate?
I wasn't to begin with, no.
I mean, did you find this together or what?
No. Dean found it before we were together.
So it came as sort of a dowry?
Yes.
How much did you pay for it?
£12,750.
That's an absolute bargain. I mean, did it not have any strings attached?
It's taken 4.5 years to get planning permission and to get all the paperwork in place to get it to the stage of being able to start work.
On top of what Dean paid for the church, they've allowed just £80,000 to cover their building work, which they hope to raise almost entirely with a mortgage.
It is my wife's wish that we can hopefully move in by December 2005.
It's 9 months away. It's going to take 9 months just to clear it out.
He says it will be ready for Christmas, and I know that he's that passionate about doing it, that it will be ready for Christmas.
If I were doing this project, I would want to employ a brilliant architect, some conservation builders, and specialists in tile work and joinery and stained glass. But Dean isn't employing any of those professions. In fact, he's not employing anybody at all. It's an approach which borders on the lunatic. And yet, there is one thing in his favour. He has had 300 meetings with his planners to get this far. With that kind of determination, maybe, just maybe, he can pull it off.
It's March, and Dean and Hillary Marks have both given up their jobs to begin converting this disused old church into a five-bedroom family home. Rather ambitiously, Dean's taken on the roles of builder, project manager, and architect.
It'd be nice to bring it back to life. If we didn't buy it, then what would happen to it? It'd probably end up a fallen wreck, and that piece of history has gone forever.
Dean and Hillary haven't secured their mortgage yet, but they take a gamble and start the build anyway, using their life savings of just £10,000. With money so tight, the whole family get involved, stripping out the old pews.
Good God. Dean, why are you ripping them apart?
This is now going to become the worktops in the kitchen.
And whatever else isn't used for the kitchen, they'll then be cut down for skirting boards and architraves.
While Hilary helps Dean, her son Jonathan does the tea run.
It's OK. Did you put sugar in?
Yeah.
Sadly, not all the pews can be recycled back into the church. The rest are ripped out and sold off as salvage to raise some extra cash. Because he's working with such a tight budget, Dean's also spent the last few years salvaging stuff from old buildings and car boot sales.
This panelling came out of a pub that's now been knocked down in Stourton, called the Stew Pony, and we intend to use it in the dining room as low-level panelling. It's all solid mahogany. The slates that we've actually got here are Welsh Riven slates. They came off a bungalow that was being demolished.
And if all this wasn't enough, Dean's got an entire container load of stuff outside.
Dean's filled it with various objects. Some of it's tat.
There's a unit there that was bought at auction, which we paid, I think it was £17 for it.
The furniture's OK, because it'll tie in with the whole church.
That was my chandelier that I managed to buy for £20 from a car boot sale.
There's some chandeliers I really hate. They will not be going in.
Got some other light fittings that came out of a job that were all scrap.
I think we'll have arguments over that. What goes up and what doesn't go in and whatever.
One of Dean and Hillary's biggest challenges will be the restoration of the 12 listed stained glass windows.
That's been boarded up since 1894. That window. That's actually going to be the landing window at the top of the stairs.
At least it's not broken, so that's one good thing.
Downstairs, they haven't been so fortunate. Just 3 months ago, vandals broke in and smashed the chancel window. Wisely, Dean's brought in stained glass expert Nick Bayliss.
Well, the window's obviously sustained a fair amount of damage, both to the glass and the lead work. Some of it can be repaired in situ, but some of them, where you've got the bad damage, where the lead's really quite badly damaged, you'll have to take out the sections, repaint up new sections of glass and insert them into the lead. You'll get that looking really nice, right. Really, really grand. And there's so much dirt and grime on it at the moment. I think once you've got all that off, I think you'll be quite amazed how nice it'll look.
We're on a very tight budget with the job.
Yeah.
Me and my wife and the family would be looking to help clean.
I can show you what to do. Say this is how to do it. And I don't mind that at all, you know, because the thing is, it's very, very time consuming.
With Nick's help, the windows will once again sparkle in majesty. Elsewhere, Dean's approach is altogether less sympathetic to the old building. The listed balcony must be kept intact, but having ripped out the old upstairs pews, Dean's now got permission to enclose it in a wall of concrete blocks. With some help, within a week, Dean's new floor plan is beginning to take shape.
Today, it stopped being a church, to be honest. I came in yesterday and the walls were about that high. And I've come in today and I've walked in and I thought, it's not like a church anymore. It feels like it's home now.
But there's a problem, a very big one. Although Dean's been working on the place for 6 weeks, the sale of the church hasn't gone through yet.
You still haven't completed on the place, which means you don't own it.
Officially not.
I mean, it must terrify you that you don't own the thing that you're working on. You're putting all this money into it.
It doesn't, because I got every confidence in the people from the church.
But this is no different to somebody buying a house and before they've even exchanged or completed, starting work on it, spending tens of thousands of pounds on the place before they own it.
I think on a standard domestic property, I think it would be very iffy and I wouldn't have done that. But considering that this was going from the church and I'd already had, well, 4.5 years involvement with them, I got no question whatsoever that it wouldn't go through.
But until it does, they don't own the place and there's no mortgage.
I don't sleep. I'll be tossing and turning and it's all going round in my head. Because we've worked so hard to get where we are now, and they can always turn around and say to us, no, stop the work, you can't do any more, put it back to the original state. And I would just be devastated.
It's all being held up by a complicated legal problem about rights of access, which could take months to resolve.
So why start? Why charge ahead?
because there was enough work to do on the property before we needed to draw down any mortgage or anything.
Yeah, albeit without you earning it. I think you're mad to start.
Some people may think so, but I think that you have to jump in and have a go. Life's a gamble. You take that risk.
To convert, do up a place like this is very brave. To convert it on a budget of £80,000 to £100,000, I mean, that is extremely ambitious. But to do it, to actually start work on the place before you even own it, I mean, that is foolhardy. Buying and doing up a church is not a straightforward process. And if this sale falls through, and it might, then all the work that Dean has done, everything here, all the money that he and Hillary have invested in this place so far, is gone.
This project is loaded with uncertainty, but Dean keeps pushing on. He's now 2 months into the project, and the inside of the church now looks a little bit like an underground car park.
So many of the features in this place have disappeared now, they've gone, and the last bit to go is this beautiful 200-year-old first floor gallery, the whole thing. But it is not being ripped out. Instead, it's going to be encased in masonry. This stays because it's got its very own listing. It's going to be entombed.
The new first floor will sit on top of these walls. But the big drawback to this design is that it creates a dark, windowless room buried in the center of the church where Dean's going to put his swimming pool. Incorporating the old balcony into the new house was always going to be a challenge, but I can't help thinking that an architect could have helped Dean find a better solution than this.
You're creating some really wacky spaces in this building. I mean, this pool right in the middle of it, enclosed, it's like a sort of a almost subterranean, you know.
I like the layout that I came up with. It'll also help Jonathan.
Of course, yeah, but it's an adventurous thing to be doing. The whole thing could be the most clever, brilliant solution as to how to make a home out of a big old box of a church like this. Or it could be a schizophrenic building. It could end up looking quite bizarre.
But whatever I think about the dangers of Dean's plans, without him, there is a possibility this church might have been pulled down like so many old buildings around here.
What powers Dean the man? What's his inspiration? What kind of keeps him going?
It's always been his passion to get this church done. Everybody says, oh no, you shouldn't do it, you shouldn't do it. And I think that is what makes him want to do it. He's like, I will do it, I'll prove my point.
He's very stubborn, though.
He's very stubborn, yeah.
It is going under. It's under here, look.
He's got a nickname, Rhino, which means he's thick-skinned and charges a lot. That just says it all with Dean.
But then where does your motivation come from? I mean, Jonathan's needs also kind of come into this, don't they? Because the pool is going to be
a major part for him.
Has he got involved much?
Like the other day, I went and picked them up from school. He said, are we going up the church? And I said, oh, no, not tonight. And he went, well, can we? And I went, well, no, not tonight. And it was like, but if I'd said to him, we're going to the church tonight, it would have been, oh, no. So I suppose you have to catch him on a good day. If we catch him on a good day, he'll do anything for you.
One thing that terrifies me about this project is the scale of it, is the size of it. I mean, here you are, you say you want to be in by the 18th of December.
At the end of the day, it's just got to be done.
You sound like him when you say that. It's got to be done.
Divorce courts, if not.
It's now 3 months into the project, and so far, progress has been pretty good. Dean's drafted some mates in to help him fit the joists for the new first floor. And for the first time, the sheer size of the task that he set himself is beginning to sink in.
Wasn't quite anticipating finding all this rubbish under the floors. I mean, in that section there, I mean, there was 14, 15 inches of just solid compacted dust that we actually used a crowbar to break it up to start with.
Dean's not the only one battling 200 years of dirt.
Nothing's happening?
Yep.
That's ridiculous.
Yep.
Absolutely no difference at all.
No.
So how long did it take, for example, to clean that little tiny patch there? You had a good go at that.
Just going over and over and over it for about 4 hours.
Well, how disheartening is that?
So, very disheartening.
So what's the solution here?
I think we'd better get Nick back and ask him.
Get him to do it, anyway.
The chancel window is so damaged, Nick's taking it away to restore.
I'm just going to lift it up now, then.
But that still leaves 10 more for Hillary to do.
Do you not feel that you've taken on too much with this?
No. I know what I want. And in life, you need to go for that. There's no good saying, I wish I'd have done that. Mm-hmm. Or, oh, I really think we should have had a go at that. Because you can never turn back the time on that. If you want to do something, then stand up, be counted, do it.
And the financing? Because you were having to borrow, weren't you?
Yeah, we're still waiting on that.
When do you run out of cash, then?
We're coming very close now. But there's a lot of work that can be done on the jobs, on the site, without needing money.
Yeah, just labouring.
Just labouring, yeah. Moving floors in the bell tower, things like that.
Without the mortgage money, Dean can't afford to pay for any more help. He's back to working slowly, doggedly, on his own.
I'm going to do the wiring myself, but it's going to be supervised by a friend of ours who's a qualified electrician as well. Once we've got our mortgage money, that's when things will move a lot better.
But he has to own this place first. You have to admire Dean's sheer determination. But he's already spent more than half of the family savings, and there's still so much to do. With no income, Dean and Hillary are forced to make some tough decisions.
I've had to go back to work. We've had no choice in that matter. It made sense for me to go, as Dean can do the hard graft, whereas really I can't. So I have kids all day at school and then I come home, and if we have problems at home, then I have to deal with those sort of problems. It is tough, but there's light at the end of the tunnel, and that's the way I look at it. Take each day as it comes.
What have you been surviving on until now?
Very little. We've been cutting back on everything. Home life has become, at times, stressful.
But I don't understand how you have managed to do all this work, and how much have you spent so far?
We think to date it's about £6,800.
You're joking?
No.
Well, I mean, excluding the labour, that's just materials, must be.
That's materials and paying for the bricklayer.
And the block laying as well. Yeah. And all those joists, all that timber.
Yes. Yeah.
I don't quite know how you've managed that. £7,000's worth so mm-hmm. far. So when are you going to finish this?
18th of December.
Well, today is the 19th of September, which makes that 3 months' time.
91 days.
There's no way.
Yes.
I mean, look, with 10 of you, yes, you've got a fighting chance. I can't believe you'll do it.
Will do.
After 7 months of hard graft, Dean and Hillary's Georgian church conversion is still little more than a shell. There's clearly no hope of moving in by their original Christmas deadline, just 10 weeks away. And with no sign of their mortgage, Dean is working heroically to keep the build going.
Hiya.
Hi, Kevin.
How are you?
Very well, thanks.
How's your building hanging?
We're getting there.
You are, aren't you? Now you've got these walls up and you've got the space enclosed, are you happy with how the building sits? I mean, how it feels?
Yes, very much so. This end of the building is working exactly as I'd visualised it to. The lounge is across from one side of the building to the other, right the way.
That's sizeable, isn't it? And in the black hole is the swimming pool.
That's where the swimming pool's going. It'd be nice because right at the very end of the swimming pool, we're looking at putting a feature on the wall there as well.
What kind of feature?
I'm speaking to an artist at the minute that will duplicate the main arch onto the back wall of the swimming pool with a landscape view. So it will actually look as though you'll stand at the front of the building, look through the hall, look through the lounge, look through the swimming pool, and then look as though you're looking out into the garden.
Dean, it had better be bloody brilliant.
I've got every confidence in the man.
Good. Now you've
upstairs, things look a lot brighter.
It's void. It's huge, isn't it?
It's a big floor space now.
It's a very large. It's like a ballroom. Blimey, these rooms are big. And they've got these great big windows in them as well. What about the cornice?
The cornice will stop.
Well, that's good. So you'll have a sort of a slice of church in your bedroom.
In every room, you will get a little piece of church on your window and a piece of cornice.
Of course, the stained glass has to stay. For Dean and Hillary to get to this point with such a tiny amount of money is nothing short of miraculous. But their savings are almost spent.
We've been going since April now. We've managed to finance the build on little bits of money that I'd got saved. And basically goodwill. It has been a struggle. Some weeks it's been very, very hard to live.
The money has finally run out, and since the wrangles over the sale of the church are still not resolved, the mortgage funds can't be released. To keep their dream alive, Hillary has to make another tough decision.
We've had to borrow money from my parents. About £7,500 to carry on with the building work. For me, it's been really, really hard. But otherwise, it would have just had to come to a standstill.
The injection of cash means work can start on turning the old pews into their new kitchen.
And then we're still using the base for the worktop.
All the base. See the worktop here?
I'll get the satisfaction that the original features of the church, okay, in a different form, are still within the building. Everybody else thinks I'm mad, but I thought it was a good idea.
Meanwhile, Hillary struggles on with the windows.
This window will probably take me about 4 days to do one window. Just cleaned with distilled water, they're supposed to be cleaned.
Hillary and Dean are now 8 months into their build, and praise be! Finally, their prayers pay off, the legal problems are resolved, and the sale of the church is completed.
Our mortgage has come through. After all the struggling we've been doing, borrowing money from here, there and everywhere, and it's great news. We can now start getting on with the bigger jobs, get the plasterboard ordered and onto the walls, hopefully. Dean's got to work a bit quicker.
With money in the bank, Dean and Hillary can splash out on some of the more expensive features of their design, like glass doors for the downstairs living room.
Oh, they ain't that heavy.
Well, this is the small panel.
But Christmas is looming. And though Dean's been working 16-hour days for the past 8 months, this project still looks miles from finishing.
There you go. Cut out for the wire up there.
Hello.
Hi, Kevin.
You're busy, aren't you?
Yes.
But there is still a huge amount to do, Dean. You know, the structure here is sort of in places still exactly as it was when I was here last. I mean, for example, plasterboard missing, plaster work missing.
Shall we just say we've got the skeleton? We've just got to put the skin on the bones.
No, it's such a huge building, this.
Well, it is a huge building, and it's always been a big project.
Yeah.
But when you look at our mortgage, we were hoping to be through for May, and we never got it till November, I think we've done really well to keep it going.
I'm not going to give you a hard time over that. I know that you were working by yourself for so long, and I appreciate that until the money came through for the mortgage, you couldn't employ anybody.
That's right.
So far, the lack of money on this project has forced Dean to play builder, project manager and architect. That's more than enough for one man. But now he's added a fourth role, interior designer.
And he said, I've chosen the ceiling rose for the lounge. And I went, no, I don't think so. And he went, yeah, I like that. And I went, well, I don't. So I've had bits and pieces taken out and...
So you're able to tinker a bit?
Yeah.
After the decision has been made?
Yeah.
But it's just the general, that's what I think will look right, where it's got to go. I can visualise more, I think, of what the whole feeling will look like once the furniture goes in.
Well, can you? Can he?
No. I think when we walk through there, the feature of the whole place is going to be the pool because you're going to be able to see it. You're not going to go, oh, look, there's a ceiling rose, are you?
Hillary's right. The swimming pool certainly grabs your attention. What is this thing here? this great roll of carpet?
That roll of carpet, as you put it, that is actually the outside wall of the swimming pool.
Good Lord, it's aluminium.
It's all aluminium.
It's like a giant tin can, isn't it? Which is decorated to look like a Roman classical frieze.
That's right, and that runs all the way around the outside of the pool.
Bizarre.
Because we're a little bit different. Because these
yes, I know, and I've always felt that. And what's it going to look like?
Once all this goes up, there's columns that go down the outside as well. You've got proper cappings all the way around the top.
Yeah.
And then we'll have steps going up each side.
So a neoclassical sardine tin swimming pool is what it's going to look like in your sitting room.
If that's the way you wish to portray it as.
Two more weeks pass by. It's now just 4 days to Christmas, and the church is a very long way from being a home.
Today is our third wedding anniversary, and we were hoping it would be new Christmas, new start, new home, everything else all sorted, and that the kids would have the house that is a dream house for Christmas.
I am really disappointed, to be honest. We wanted the church really to be a fresh start for all of us as a family. And it was really significant that we moved in for Christmas because we thought it was a family time and it would have been nice, but not to be this year.
I've agreed I'm going to have Christmas Day, Boxing Day and the day after, and then it's back to work. If you want the dream, get off your butt and get up and do it. Nobody else is going to do it for you.
Almost a year into the build, and a paint job has at least revitalised the outside of the church. And today, a team arrives to fit Dean's crowning glory to the top of the bell tower, his plastic dome.
Fantastic. It's the icing on the cake. Long time in the coming, but it's there. It's exactly what I envisaged seeing on the top of this tower.
Not me. I've always found the idea grotesquely inappropriate. But at least the listed stained glass windows have been carefully repaired, and Nick is back to fit them.
Yeah, that looks really fine. Have you re-leaded the whole thing? You have, haven't you?
We had to, really. It's such a big window that strength-wise it needed re-leading. But the main thing is that you keep as much of the glass as possible, you know, or all of the glass where necessary, you know.
Yeah, I'd love to see it from the inside.
When this window was taken away, it was broken and grubby. Thanks to Nick, it's been colourfully and gloriously restored. With 200 years of dirt and damage removed, this window will be the centrepiece of Dean and Hillary's sitting room, if they ever finish.
So it's really good to see the glass going in, but how is progress generally?
Progress is moving. It isn't fast.
So when do you expect to finish?
I'm not going to say. I don't know. I'd like to be in by the end of June.
I know you do have the stamina to finish it. It's whether or not your heart is still in it.
Oh, my heart's still there, 100%. I've lost no enthusiasm for the building whatsoever. It's a dream. It's my life.
I'm pleased to see that Dean's taken the trouble to fit a bespoke oak staircase, which adds some character to the conversion. And upstairs is now almost plastered out. But it's been 18 months since they began, and for Hillary, it's been a very long haul.
Were you happy?
It's just taken a lot longer than I thought it would. I'm going to start putting this up. This has got to be done today. This has got to be done today. Because I'll come sometimes and I go, what have you done today?
And then, you know, there's a lot of labour, a lot of materials in this place. It's huge.
It's amazing what he's done with, really, because it's only been him some days. You know, I'm pleased with the progress he's made, but it's just slow.
Hard to keep the faith, though, isn't it? I mean, if you keep getting told, oh, it'll be next month or it'll be June, you know, and it isn't.
I don't listen to him anymore. I just think, oh, it'll be done when it's done and that's it. So I don't let it worry me now. And that's the best way to be, I think, with Dean.
So you've learnt something about him?
Yeah, yeah. And I've probably learnt something more about me as well, because I'm more patient, actually, than I thought I would be.
I can understand Hillary's frustrations, but converting this church with such a tiny budget was, frankly, always going to take time.
How is the budget now? I mean, how much have you spent, do you know?
To date, we've spent £64,000.
I can't believe that. I cannot believe you spent so little money.
It's a case of having to shop round. I've bought reclaimed stuff from where I can, and it's come at the right money. I mean, £80 for a solid mahogany staircase.
Yeah, well, that's phenomenal. Seems to me that every room is kind of brimming with deals.
They have to.
Dean's deals.
That's why we can afford to do what we do. I mean, yes, I've bought stuff that will be sold later because it won't fit in. But some of the stuff we've bought has worked really well. I'm trying to achieve a family home, not a show home. I want it to be lived in and I want the kids to enjoy it.
With autumn comes a big push. The plastering's almost finished, and at long last, Dean begins to decorate some of the rooms. There is visible progress.
Starting to get the kitchen fitted now, at last. These units that I'm now putting in, the top is actually made out of the pews. The cupboard doors for the backrests of the pews. It's just keeping the character, which is the main part of it, retaining as much in the building as what we can.
Well, that which Dean hasn't already ripped out or covered up. Slowly, Dean and Hillary's new home is replacing the old church. But he has at least brought in some more professionals to show him how to restore the old ceramic floors.
So then we'll dry the floor off. The type of tile that you've got here is porous to a degree, so over the years, the dirt has worked its way into the tile. However, we live in hope that we're going to get it in an excellent condition.
To my relief, Dean's given up the idea of the mural for the swimming pool. Instead, he's decided to add some colour with the strangest ceiling I've ever seen. It's like a giant piece of blue cling film. And once it's heated, or blow-dried in this case, it literally shrink-fits in place. Of all the areas in the church, this has to be the most bizarre. Elsewhere, progress is more conventional.
We're at the stage where we're on to final finishings. Bathroom suites and that can start to go in. It's hard work, but we're pushing on with it. And I think Hillary's happy now that she can see things happening.
Yeah, I think my favourite place is the kitchen. I didn't expect it to turn out as well as it has. I'm really pleased with it.
After spending almost 2 years of their lives struggling with this place, Dean and Hillary have no illusions about the energy needed to finish it.
Next 4 weeks, I think we'll be here 24/7. Dean comes straight here and I see him about half 12 on the night. I come up for maybe 4 or 5 hours and leave here about 9. Whether it'll be done or not, I don't know, but hopefully, yeah.
After 2 grueling years working ceaselessly, Hillary and Dean and their children have moved into their converted church in Dudley.
Good morning, Kevin. Nice to see you.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Yeah, it's looking good on the outside. Very crisp, you know. How's the inside?
Getting there.
Well.
Welcome to our new home.
Well, goodness me. What a home. Do you know, I'm really pleased you've kept these tombstones and kept the altar rail, all that. And you walk in, you feel as though you're walking into a church.
It's nice to keep the bits of history, like memorial and things like that.
How do you feel now you're in?
I love it. It's nice now because we can just walk in and it's home. The kids love it. They really do.
Well, I like this space. I like the double height space above the stairwell. It is, sadly, the only place in the building now where you can see appreciate the original height of the building.
We needed
the space for the other rooms as well.
The layout of this church has always been problematic. The kitchen that runs across the back of the building, the narrow dining room, and the living room are all squeezed around the central swimming pool.
This space, oh God, oh, this is dominated by this monstrosity of a pool.
It's not that bad.
Well, it was mainly for Jonathan so that he got his exercise with his legs and everything else.
Oh, that I understand.
I think I would have preferred if we hadn't got the glass. If I couldn't see it, then I don't think it would be a problem, but I don't like it.
Yeah, I'm with you
there. I think it looks a bit like a font when you walk in.
A big plastic font. Yeah, in a Baptist church for total immersion.
The swimming pool is overwhelming, but at least the blue ceiling sinks into the background.
The more serious problem I've got with this room is I don't think this feels like a room, because your eye's being drawn out of it all the time, and when you're in this space, it's being divided by these massive overhanging blocks, which are effectively, this is the encased, the entombed.
The entombed, the gallery.
Up there, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. So that creates more difficulty. How's the dining room?
The dining room's come on really well.
So
really,
I haven't seen any of the stained glass because it's always been boarded up. Oh, you see, I like this room. It's beautiful. There's a beautiful cast iron post that's always been here, and you've got this Lord's Prayer and the Ten Commandments. It's great.
All that came out of where the kitchen is now on the back wall.
Well, that's great. It's got a sort of, well, you can sort of understand that it was a church here, can't you? There's an ecclesiastical feel to the room.
Yeah, well, all the panelling and everything was all reclaimed timber. We've sanded the original floors.
Yeah.
We've cleaned all the glass up and had all the glass repaired where it was broken.
The glass, now that you've uncovered it, is magnificent, isn't it, on this side?
It's beautiful, isn't it?
It really is.
The kitchen, too, is a pretty good success.
Do you know, I really tire of all those kind of modern, granite-topped, glossy kitchens, and this is really heartening to see this, you know? This is entirely recycled, isn't it? Yep.
This is all of the pews.
Whenever Dean manages to use the old building and work with it, the project suddenly springs to life.
It's a big kitchen, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a big party kitchen.
Oh, yeah? Is that what it's going to be for, Hilary?
I love this kitchen.
Despite the sense of fun and indulgence, some of the spaces in this building are really not good or coherent. And in places, there are some over-the-top and extravagant ideas. The layout upstairs is more conventional. As a result, the bedrooms are light, generous, and very usable.
Oh, do you know, I do like that bed. Those are the old pews from downstairs, aren't they?
Yes.
That's really clever. Nice job. I thought this place would be dark.
Yeah.
You know? It's not.
It's a magical building. Once the sun starts coming into the building itself.
Mm, all that stained glass.
I'm rather staggered at the opulence of their huge ensuite bathroom, a touch of modern hotel luxury in this bizarre church conversion. The bell tower is also an odd blend of old and new.
You know, it's like a sort of labyrinthine staircase in an altered medieval bell tower or library, which is what it's going to be, isn't it?
It is good.
And I like the brick, the finish of the brick. That's nice and raw. Blimey, O'Reilly, look at this. You can see for miles.
Literally.
Miles of it. What a fun space this is.
Yes.
Having this little observation tower is great. From down there, of course, it's also bloody ugly, this thing. It is absolutely hideous. What about you, Hilary? Do you like it?
I don't like it from the outside.
No, that's funny, that, yeah.
Yeah, I don't like it from the outside. But once you're up here, I quite like the... It's nice and quiet, it's...
Do you know, I mean, I agree with you. The experience of being up here is really good fun.
Yeah.
You know, it's a laugh.
Dean's limited budget may have resulted in some crippling shortcuts on this project, like the plastic dome, but this is a huge place. And it's incredible to have achieved this much with just £120,000.
I can't believe you've done this for £120,000.
The good thing is we haven't had to pay much out on labour because I've
Even when the bricklayers were in, I was the one doing all the labouring for them, which meant I was in at 4 o'clock in the morning loading all the scaffolds out and everything for them.
But how's it been? Because you haven't, you know, you're not one of these self-builders who halfway through the project takes a three-week holiday in the West Indies. How many days off have you had in 2 years?
In 2 years, I've probably had about 6 days off, 7 days.
And that's including weekends?
Yes.
It has been hard. It's been hard with on a weekend more than anything, really. Because we've had to come here with the children, and it's been hard because you don't come back until about 10:30 on a night, so he doesn't see them all week anyway.
And it's a big reduction in the quality of your life, so is it all worth it in the end?
Yes. To sacrifice that and to get what we've got, I'm quite happy, really. I don't know how I'll cope with him being at home. I have to send him on another project, I think.
Don't say that. No, look, I know you had no money. Do you think now that you should have consulted a designer or an architect, that somehow you should have found a way of getting the design to work harder and better?
I feel the way that it's laid out at the minute works. It's some things people might say, oh no, I don't know why you wanted a swimming pool, or why you want Hill's dad said, why have a swimming pool? But I suppose it's probably because I'm stubborn and I decided that's what was going to go into there, and like most architects are stubborn.
Okay, in which case, are you happy with the finished product?
I enjoy this house. I enjoy coming here. You know, it's just something that we'd never have dreamt of having, really. Just nice to be able to have the space with the children now.
I'm a working class guy. There's no airs and graces. What you see is what you get. And hopefully what I've done is provided my family now with a wonderful home for us all, and it's at a cost that we can afford to live here.
You know, I've never been so divided over a project. On the one hand, it broke my heart to see so much of the character, the integrity of this place disappear to be replaced by some pretty hideous features and a rather clunky layout. On the other, Hillary and Dean's commitment to this project has been inspiring. The risks they have taken have been extraordinary. And remember this, without them, none of this glass would have been restored. In fact, in 10 years' time, this place might even have fallen to pieces. So whether or not you or I like what Dean has done, thanks to him, this place is still here.